Ladies and gentlemen, Oakland's master storyteller, Mr. Don Reed. Hello, everyone. Clap for you. Clap for you. Go. Pimps. Out, out, ooh, out, 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 ooh, ow, 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 ow. Pimps, pimps. Out, out, ooh, out, 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 ooh, ow. A brakadoo boom, 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 boom. A pimps be stomping their heels on East 14th. A pimps be sliding in caddies down East 14th. Pimps be spitting that game on East 14th. A pimps be living the life on East 14th. A plot, got, 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 out, out, ooh, out, 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 ooh, out. I grew up on East 14th in Oakland, California. Out, out, ooh, out, 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 ooh, out. In the 70s, when I was like 10 or 12 years old, my mother and father divorced and my mother remarried. She married a guy who made us be in that religion where they knock on your door at 7 o'clock in the morning. You know that religion when they knock on your door at 7 o'clock in the morning? The one they knock on your door at 7 o'clock in the morning? The one they knock on your door at 7 o'clock in the damn morning? The one that rhymes with Jehovah's Witnesses. You know what I'm talking about? With the no birthdays, no Christmas, and definitely no pepper, you definitely can not do the pepper in that religion at all. And as a teenager, all I could think about is doing the pepper to somebody. So at age 16, I got tired of all the rules and the regulations, and I decided to move from the kind of middle class area with the and the picket fences to the other end of East 14th to go live with my real father. Out, out, ooh, out, 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 ooh, out. I think I went too far. See, I'd gone to the other extreme. My older half-brothers already lived there. One older brother was a player, a ladies' man. My other brother wanted to be a lady. Oh, no, he did. He was uber gay. He was extra gay. Other gay people go, Don't be that gay. And my father, my dear old dad, he just so happened to be a pimp. But I didn't know it. I just thought he was really into hats. So set your watches back to 1970-something and come with me down to East 14th. A true tale of a reluctant player. Out, out, ooh, out, 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 ooh, out. Chick, 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 chick. Out, 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 ooh, out. When I was like 9 years old, everybody called me Blinky because I used to bat my eyes like crazy. Bling, 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 bling. And I did that all the way up into my teen years. So my teen years, I'm knocking on doors 100 hours a month, spreading the word, blinking. Just a nervous mess, right? A power nerd. I was a power nerd. So by the time I moved over to my father's house, my older brother, Daryl, player, had plenty, plenty girlfriends. He walked up to me one day. He was like, yo, 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 yo. You know what, man? You ain't cool at all. We need to work on you. We need to get you right, get set you straight. You know what? The main thing we need to do? We need to fix your hair. My brother's trying to convince me, because I had a nice size afro at the time, that I needed to part my hair down the center and perm it to what was called our Lord Jesus cut. Part my hair down the center and perm it to what was called a Lord Jesus cut. But I was a little reluctant to do it because my friend named Donnell had done it and it didn't turn out too good. Donnell was a nice black, like black, like National Geographic black, right? And Donnell had experimented and put some blonde highlights in his hair. Dark skin, blonde hair. He looked like a water buffalo. Didn't look good at all. I finally did mine, and it turned out great. No blonde highlights at all, though, right? So one day, my brother walks in. Yo. Check this out. Today, we're gonna go roller skating, and we're gonna meet us some girls down at the lake. Now, you gotta understand what Lake Merritt was like in the 1970s. In the middle of our diverse concrete jungle was the oasis, Lake Merritt, where people met on sunny Sundays to roller skate and dance, roller skate and drink, roller skate and hit on each other all day long. And we were gonna go, but we couldn't find any hair care products anywhere in the house. Could find nothing to do our Lord Jesus is with. My brother Daryl turned on my brother Tony and said, yo. I know why we ain't even got no backup emollients in the house. It's because Tony used them all up. My brother Tony's like, I don't need none of that stuff to do my hair. My hair is immaculate. I said, don't you mean immaculate? He's like, whatever it is, whatever you call it, my hair look good. My brother's like, look, I found a little bit of something to do my hair with. You find something. You catch the bus. He took off. I gotta catch the bus? I gotta catch the bus, but I'm going. I'm going roller skating. I'm gonna meet me some girls if it was the last thing I do today. I'm gonna roller skate and meet some girls. I looked all over the house for something to do my hair with. Every drawer, every shelf, looked at every room, every place. And I finally found something. In the kitchen. Some butter. That's greasy, ain't it? So I swear to God, I got a big gob of butter, and I went in the bathroom mirror and I started rubbing it into that Lord Jesus hairstyle. And at first it kinda looked like I had some damn butter in my hair, because that's what it was, right? But I kept working on it until it got a nice sheen, and you couldn't tell it was butter at all. And I was ready to go roller skating at the lake. Yeah! Out. I'm walking down the street to the bus stop, and I stop along the way to check my hair in a side view mirror in the car, and the sun is melting it. It's looking even sheenier. I was like, yeah! I misjudged though how long the walk was gonna be down to the bus stop. It was getting kind of hot. I'm like, it's getting hot. I'm trying to keep my enthusiasm on, but I checked my hair in another side view mirror along the way, and I realized I was sweating a little butter down just like that, like a little butter river. I'm like, that's not good at all. But I kept going because I want to go roller skating. So I'm walking. And it's getting hotter and hotter. Finally get down to the bus stop. The bus shows up. The doors open and that cool air conditioning wafted and wafted upon me. I'm like, yeah, that feels good. I paid my money. I walked towards the back. I sat in that seat near the back by that bulbous mirror. You know that bulbous mirror back there where the bus driver watches, you know, bad kids trying to sneak on or old ladies getting off safely? I sat back there by that bulbous mirror, and about 15 minutes into the ride, I was feeling cool and rejuvenated, like, yeah! Another 15 minutes into the ride, at some point, I caught my reflection in that bulbous mirror. Apparently, the air conditioning on the bus had acted as some kind of refrigeration unit. And my hair turned stark white. Dark skin, white hair. I look like a water buffalo. I got off the bus, people like, damn, he looked like a water buffalo. What's going on? Why is his hair white? Is he an old man? What the hell's going on with him, right? But I remembered heat. I remembered heat. So off the bus, I got back into another side view mirror off a car. I got it back to Sheen. I worked on it. I got it back. I said, that's what warmth of Sheen it up, okay? I got it back to Sheen, and you couldn't tell it was butter at all. I was ready to roller skate and meet you some girls, yeah! I went over to where they rent the roller skates, and I saw this girl named Latana. I said, hey, Latana. How you doing? You know the look somebody's giving you when they're looking you right in the eyes or 2 inches up at your new messed up hairstyle? She's like, But I don't know why she would be doing that, because I just remelted it and it should look good. I was about to find out what was going on, right? I said, hey, Latana, did you rent your skates? Or did you... Did you rent your skates or do you own... About 300 gnats and 2 flies. I said, Eureka, this brother wore some butter in his hair down to the lake. Bon appetite, right? And I remember trying to play it off. I'm like, look at all these gnats and flies. All over the place. She's like, no, they ain't all over the place. They just right over your head right there. Like a black cloud, they congregated there. I see him. I said, Latana, I'll talk to you later, okay? I'm gonna skate with you later. So I went like 150, 200 yards away from everybody and everything by myself down to the edge of the lake to make sure it was me and the butter that was causing such a commotion. It was definitely me. I started heading home. My brother called out from way across the way. He's like, yo. Where are you going? There's a whole bunch of girls over here. I said, there's a whole bunch of gnats and flies over here. I'm taking my ass home. I remember sitting at the bus stop, seeing those commercials for Africa with those poor children having to deal with all those damn flies. But they have higher priorities than shooing away flies, so they're just sitting there doing like this, and they're like, if I shoo one away, another one's just gonna come right back. So I'm sitting there dealing with that. They're doing figure eights on my face. I'm like, this is not good at all. And I was like, forget it. A little later, my father, the pimp, the same one who pushed me to go to finish high school, go to UCLA, he came to me around that time. He said, you know what, baby, the reason why things ain't working out for you is you're trying to be something you ain't, all right? All you need to do is be yourself. All you gotta do is just be your damn self. And to that I say, thank you, Daddy. Thank you, guys.
If you like what you heard, support amazing storytelling. Donate now at snapjudgment.org.